This is Jerry Agar on Newstalk 1010.
Find yourself in People's City. Stay a while if you can.
So what are you thinking of as you listen to that song? You might not immediately think what the writers, producers, singer of that song wanted you to think. Now, some years ago in Toronto, you may have done so. See, what they were hoping for Toronto, was something like what has happened for many other cities. There are so many cities that I think with very little effort, most people could name the song that's about the city. I'm going to Kansas City, Chicago, State Street, that great street, the New York, New York, no doubt. And yet, my panelist Ed Conroy has stayed because he did a documentary. It's a great documentary on the song that was supposed to be that song for Toronto, but it isn't.
It's not, no. It should be. It should be.
Was it, for its brief time, and we'll play a piece of it again in a moment, for its brief time, was it the song of Toronto?
Absolutely. I mean, people have...
And when was that time?
Well, okay, so the song was written and produced and released in 1972, so okay. 45 years ago. And for about 10 years, Toronto was known as People City, in the same way that nowadays people say, oh, the Six... You know, yeah. Drake and his guys made these songs about the Six, and everybody acts as if that's never happened before. But it actually did happen, and I think People City is a much cooler moniker for Toronto than the Six.
Well, Tommy Ambrose was chosen as one of the creators. Moses Neimer commissioned it for City TV and wanted it to become the city song, and Tommy Ambrose is the singer on the song People City. And in your documentary, he talks about how it did at first.
And you heard the song a lot. Because City was watched a lot, and it was all over the place. And places like CFRB played that song. Wally Crowder played that record because it was on a 45. He played it because he loved the song.
And Moses Neimer tells us that one of the things that happened is, to some degree, Wally Crowder, CFRB, is not John Moore in the Morning and Jerry Agar. It's a different radio station. It's a different city. Here's Moses Neimer.
As the city grew, the tempo of the city began to get more urgent and strident, and the song began to feel, a little dated.
You think that's true?
Well, I mean, you got to understand, it was commissioned as a sign-off song. And people, again, this is hard to imagine now, that television stations used to sign off, you know, after midnight. They'd say, yeah. Okay, it's time to go to bed. We'll see you again in the morning.
And they would play God Save the Queen.
They play O Canada. And when Moses, being the genius that he was, he wanted to disrupt the world of television. He said, I don't want to play O Canada. This is a television station that is for Toronto. I want a theme song for Toronto, and I want a love song for Toronto. And so he found these guys, Tommy Ambrose and writer Gary Gray, who were like the Lennon and McCartney of the jingles world.
Yeah.
And, he said, go nuts, write a love song about Toronto. And they went out and got an orchestra. And, Tommy, he came from the gospel background. So there, it's almost got a hymn-like quality.
Sure, we'll hear it again in a moment. But these people who worked on it also came from the jingle background. And they were the community you went to here in Toronto. If you had a company and you needed a jingle for your, well, here's Tommy Ambrose doing a Kool-Aid commercial.
They don't make them like that anymore.
No, that's
great. Great day in the morning.
Great day in the morning.
It's a full speed ahead. Things look great day when the kids make their own grape Kool-Aid. And believe, they made your day a little happier. Grape Friday. Just want to set
there is a gospel thing there, isn't there?
Totally, totally. And I mean... Yeah.
He's not only going to tell you about Kool-Aid, he's going to make you believe.
He's got soul. I mean, he really, Anne Murray described Tommy as the greatest vocalist in Canadian history.
Anne Murray said that?
Anne Murray said
that. I thought she was it.
Well, She's modest.
No,
right?
But I mean, with her saying that, that matters.
Yeah, it's legit. No, yeah. I mean, it absolutely is legit. And it's funny, you know, talk about New York, New York. I mean, that song, everybody associates it with Frank, but a few people realize that it was actually written for Liza Minnelli in the Scorsese movie, New York, New York.
Yeah.
But now everybody associates it with the Big Apple, with the city, in the same way that People City was commissioned for City TV, but it really should have a life of its own beyond that.
Well, however, Zneimer may be correct, and that is that it was a song not just about the city, but it was about a time. And whereas New York, New York seems timeless.
Well,
and maybe that's where we lost out with the song.
Yes and no. I mean, look, People City, the concept of a city full of diverse people is truer now than it even was in 1972. I think what it comes down to is New York, New York is a sort of standard, and it's covered by tons of artists, whereas People City, if it had been covered by Tony Bennett or by visiting artists, it might have been different.
All right, let's listen to it again. This is People City.
That's when you learn that you're in Toronto. That's People City. Yes, People City. We're in Toronto.
I think you're right. If major artists would have picked it up and done it the way that has happened with some of those Chicago songs or San Francisco, those songs, they would also, in their time, put a little touch on it that sort of made it a little more contemporary, and we'd all know the song. So you did the documentary, Ed Conroy is here, on this song. It's about a 22-minute video. I really enjoyed it. Where can people find it?
It's on my website, retroontario.com. It's going to be on the Museum of Toronto website, M-Y-S-E-U-M. They're also doing an exhibit right now called Music from People City, which is a citywide exhibit, a bunch of pop-up events. So definitely check out their website. But we're really celebrating this amazing anthem for Toronto that is much cooler than the Six. I mean, come on.
Okay. Once again, first website, just so people can remember one.
It's retroontario.com. RetroOntario.com.
Thanks for being here.
Thank you for having me.
So spread your sunshine all over the place and put on a